Brahmana, generally, he understands the purpose of life. He's convinced about the goal of life. He's not going to waste the valuable opportunity of the human form of life.
婆罗门他们知道人生的意义所在，他们知道怎样小心翼翼地使用一用他们的人生，不会浪费虚掷人生。
But the kripana, the miserly person, they're simply concerned with the material body. They only want sense gratification.
Kripana他们只是对感官享乐感兴趣，他们只关注于怎样让躯体健康。
So that the Vedic literatures were meant for the Brahmanas.
所以韦达文献是给那些婆罗门的。
But in the Brahma Samhita, Lord Brahma says, Vedeshu Durlabham, that it's very difficult to know Krishna from the Vedas.
在婆罗门赞当中说, Vedeshu Durlabham, 要通过韦达经了解, Krishna是很难的。
You may read all the Vedas, you won't. So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Trigunya Vishaya Veda, nice Trigunya Bhavaja. Rise above the modes, the Vedas deal with the three modes of nature. Rise above the modes, Arjuna.
主克什那在国家梵歌当中训示，阿尔朱那要超越物质三自然三形态，超越韦达经所训示的这些形态。
The Vedas will teach all kinds of, a lot of karma kandi, fruitive activities, how to get benefits, how to enjoy material life. And they only teach very little, they just give a glimpse about the real goal of the Vedas, which is to get devotion.
所以韦达经中大量的是 karma kanda 之物，对于奉献服务只描述的是很少。So
the Vedic literatures are not as important as the Puranic literature.
所以韦达经并不像普拉那往事宇宙故事那样重要。In
the Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva begins the Bhagavatam by describing that the Vedas, the Vedic knowledge is like a tree.
在圣地伯加瓦坛当中呢，Srila Vyasadeva一开篇就说，韦达经就好像树干。
And the fruit of the tree is the Srimad Bhagavatam.
而这棵树的果实就是圣地伯加瓦坛。
So the Srimad Bhagavatam is more valuable than the Vedas.
所以圣地伯加瓦坛比韦达经更加珍贵。
Because the Vedic knowledge keeps us in it gives us some pleasures from the material world, but often it doesn't help us to get out of the material
world.
So Daksha, he's thinking more about the Brahmanas. See, because the Brahmanas, they're all supporting Daksha. They're all on his side.
在这里呢，Daksha他想的只是那些婆罗门，因为那些婆罗门都站在他这一边。Daksha
is one of their leaders, so they're very respectful to him.
Daksha是婆罗门的首领，所以深受婆罗门的尊重。But
we'll see in the course of the encounter, we'll see there's a great fight takes place between the followers of Daksha and the followers of Lord Shiva.
那么看到在后面的章节当中就描述说，在 Daksha 的追随者和主 Shiva 追随者之间就有一场很大的冲突。
And they curse each other.
他们彼此之间互相诅咒。
The Brahmanas, they curse the followers of Lord Shiva that they'll all become atheists.
婆罗门诅咒主 Shiva 的追随者，你们都变成无神论者。
And the followers of Shiva, they curse the Brahmanas that you will be practitioners of dull, meaningless rituals.
主Shiva的追随者诅咒那些婆罗门，你们都变成愚钝的、这个没有用的规范原则的追随者。
And both curses are in effect today.
效。
Shivites, people who are generally Shivites, they think God has no form.
那些主 Shiva 的追随者们，他们认为神是没有无形无相。
The Brahmanas simply do rituals for their own material needs.
婆罗门只是为了自己的维持，为了自己的生计，举行仪式。
So we don't want to become like these followers of Shiva or these Brahmanas.
我们不想成为主 Shiva 的这些追随者，也不想成为 Brahmanas.
We do want to get the mercy of Lord.
我们确实要想得到主 Shiva 的仁慈。
The mercy of Lord, the real mercy of Shiva is not to fulfill our material desires, but to give us our spiritual blessings.
像主 Shiva 的仁慈并不是有利于我们完成我们的物质愿望，而是让我们得到灵性好处。
And the Brahmanas, the real Brahmanas, they will also guide us. They'll give us the proper knowledge of the scriptures.
Brahmana, 婆罗门，他们也能在伟达经方面给对经典方面给我们正确的指导。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a verse which says that even if one is born in a sudra family.And a low-born family which eats dog meat, but they can perform a Vedic sacrifice simply by once chanting the holy name.
圣典国家瓦坛有这样的记载和这样的正确的唱诵了 Krishna 的圣名，他也有资格举行韦达的仪式。
Now, usually to do a Vedic sacrifice, you have to be a twice initiated Brahmana.
一般而言，要举行。伟达的火祭，一个人要得到二次出生，成为婆罗门。
But anybody who chants the holy name of the Lord, they immediately become qualified to do this sacrifice.
但是，一个吟诵一唱主 Krishna 圣名的人，立刻有资格能够举行这些仪式。
Even if they're born in a family where their family was dog eating.
即便他们诞生于吃狗肉的家庭。
Now, dog eating is a bit, that's very low. It's not very considered very good.
吃狗肉的人被认为是很低等的，并不是很好的习惯。
It's common in some countries like Philippines and Korea.
那在像菲律宾和韩国、朝鲜这样的国家，吃狗肉很盛行。
Sometimes in China also.
在中国也有这种。地方也有这样习惯。
Sometimes even eat snakes.
有时候还有人吃蛇。
Not very good things to eat.
还吃一些不是很好的食物。
But if we chant the holy name, then we can remove all of that past karma.
但是，一旦我们开始唱诵圣名，所有这些过往的 karma 因果都能够消除。
Prabhupada was telling one devotee about going to preach in the Far East, and he was saying, "Oh, Prabhupada, they eat dogs there, they eat snakes there." Prabhupada said, "In your country, people eat cows. He said, it's worse."
有一次，释迦牟尼就命令他一个门徒去森林当中传教。然后这个门徒就说，释迦牟尼他们会在那里吃蛇吃狗。然后释迦牟尼说，在你的国度。那里的人们还吃母牛呢。
It's worse.
那比那吃狗和吃蛇更糟糕。
It's more sinful.
那比那个更加罪恶。
So, even people have bad karma. By the influence of our karma, we're in these situations where we eat this kind of food.
一个人是由于他过往的 karma。业报才得到吃这样食物的习惯。
But when we chant the holy name, then all that karma can be removed.
一旦他开始
The name of the Lord is so powerful, it destroys all the best karmas.
主的圣名是这样强大有力，可以消除抵消所有这些过往业报。
And it brings one to the platform of the mode of goodness.
将一个人提升到善良属性。
That's the position of a Brahmana.
那也就是婆罗门的资格。
Of course, we don't just simply want to be a Brahmana.
当然，我们的目的不是成为婆罗门。
But Brahmana, one who is on the platform of Brahman, means is understood. He is not the body.
但是，一个他处在泛的层面的人，被认为他应该是认已经觉悟到自己不是这个躯体。
Then devotional service begins from that point.
奉爱服务始于这个层面。
You have to come to this platform, the mode of goodness. From the mode of goodness, then you can understand transcendental knowledge.
一个人应该晋升到善良属性这个层面，然后他才能进而理解超然的知识。
These four principles, they are the pillars of a civilized society.
这四项原则是一个文明社会的支柱。
When the people will follow these four principles, then the society will be very peaceful and prosperous.
当一个社会的人们他遵守这四项规范守则的时候，这个社会是繁荣而平静的。
People will live in harmony, will be happy in their lives. They will not be envious, will not be greedy, they will be actually happy.
那么社会的氛围是一种平和、快乐、满足的氛围，而不会有嫉妒、愤怒。
Srila Prabhupada used to tell people, there's only one scarcity in the world, and that is Krishna consciousness.
史德帕布哈德他常常说，在社会上只有一个匮乏，那就是匮乏 Krishna 知觉。
We are making so many plans for economic development. We want to be prosperous materially. That does not bring happiness.
人们忙于制定各种各样的经济发展的策略计划，但并不能使人带来内心的平和满足。
But when people live according to the plan of according to the instructions of the Vedas, they are there to guide us so that we can live peacefully.
但如果人们遵守韦达经的教导，这样会导致人们过上平和快乐的生活。
You may say, just like when you purchase some device, you get a manual, an operating instruction, how to use it. So the same way, when you get a human body, the Vedas are there to guide us. They give us instructions, how we should live, how we should act.
就好像一个人他购买了一个大件的机器，电子机器的时候会有的说明书怎样使用这台机器，同样的韦达经也是伴随着人类是指导人类该如何使用人类的生活。
People think, I'm free, I can do whatever I like, I don't need to follow these rules.
有的人会想啊，我是自由自在的，我无所谓，不用关注所有这些规范。
I can do whatever I like.
我可以随心所欲，想怎么做怎么做。
But they're controlled by their mind and senses.
可是他们却被自己的感官心意所控制。
And they're forced to act under the control of the modes of nature.
他们被迫按照物质自然属性而行动。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Prakrite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasha ahankara vigunatma.The bewildered spirit soul, under the influence of material nature, thinks himself to be the doer of activities which are carried out by the modes of nature.
薄伽梵歌说，受条件限制的灵魂，他们被迷惑，以为自己是行为者，但实际上所有这些活动。
So material nature forces the conditioned soul to act.
物质自然三形态迫使受条件限制的灵魂被迫的行动。
They're not free. They think I'm doing what I like. I'm free, but they're not free. They're controlled by the material nature.
他们以为自己是自由的，可以想做什么做什么。他们是被物质自然三形态所控制。
But a devotee knows that he's acting under the control of the Supreme Lord.
但是一个奉献者知道他是按照至尊主的控制来行动。So
either way, we're controlled, either by material nature or the spiritual nature.
我们或者是被物质自然所控制，或者是被灵性的自然控制。
This is our independence, our free will to choose either to be controlled by Krishna or by Maya.
这是我们的独立性，我们可以选择，或者是被 Krishna 所控制，或者是被 Maya 所控制。So
Daksha is chosen to be controlled by Maya.
Daksha 他选择被 Maya 所控制。
Okay, any questions?
就是你刚才说到那个佛门，就是和那个西瓦神，他们两个人的这个诅咒，就是用什么方法，就是他到现在还影响我们现在的人啊，就是用什么样的方法可以解除这样的诅咒呢？
You just mentioned that the Brahmanas and the Saivas, they curse each other, and the curse is still effective until these days. How can we counteract the curses?
How can we counteract the curse?
How can these curses? How can these curses not affect us?
Well, the curses don't affect us.
这些诅咒不会影响我们。
We're not followers of Lord Shiva.
我们不是Shiva的追随者。
Right? We may offer our respects to Lord Shiva, and we may seek the blessings of Lord Shiva to get devotion for Krishna. But we're not just simply following only Shiva. The followers of Shiva, they simply follow Shiva. They don't listen to anybody.
那些主Shiva的追随者，他们只听主Shiva的，他们别的都不听。
They don't understand that Shiva is a devotee of the Supreme Lord.
他们不明白主Shiva实际上是至尊主的奉献者。And
the Brahmins also, these Brahmins are the ritualistic Brahmins. These are not the Vaishnava Brahmins.
那些婆罗门，他们只是仪式性的婆罗门，他们不是。
Vaishnava. A real Brahmana is a devotee, a Vaishnava. So devotee Brahmanas, they don't waste their time doing dull rituals. Spend their time chanting the holy name. And worshipping the deities. Studying scriptures like Srimad
Bhagavatam.
So that curse is on these caste brahmanas.
这些诅咒是施加在那些, 种姓婆罗门身上的。
网络上面有两个问题。 感谢马拉吉讲课，感谢古鲁玛尼的马太吉的翻译。达克沙地位崇高，学识渊博，他怎么浑然不知主希瓦的地位呢？对，而对主希瓦做出了冒犯呢？是否学识渊博也无法保证人不会做出冒犯 ？Ramahansa Sutta 也是学识渊博的学者，也冒犯了主巴拉拉玛。如果知识不能保证人不冒犯，那么这些知识有什么价值呢？谢谢，Hare Krishna。
vast knowledge, how can he not know the position of Shiva and offend Lord Shiva? Whether that the vast knowledge cannot secure one from offenses. My question is that even if one is very learned, that knowledge cannot prevent him, cannot ensure that he is not offensive. This is the first part. And then Brother Brahma Harsha's Sutta is also very learned, but he offends Lord Balarama. If the knowledge cannot ensure that one cannot be not offensive, so what's the value of the knowledge? Thank you. The second part, in the material world.
No. So, what is the value? Daksha, we said he has a very high position. He's a powerful personality in the universe.
Daksha, he is a very high position.
You could understand, he must have been very powerful because Sati, who becomes Shiva's wife, was his daughter. You know, we see like Lord Ramachandra's wife was Sita, and Sita was the daughter of a great king, Maharaj Janaka. And similarly, Radharani, she was the daughter of Maharaj Vrishabhanu. So to have such a wonderful, such a powerful daughter, to have the parents have to be very great also. So Daksha had a very big position. And Srimad Bhagavatam describes how his body effulgence was greater than even the gods of fire. But somehow he became affected by the fact that Lord Shiva didn't respect him. Now, Lord Chaitanya teaches us Amanina Manadena. Right? In the Shikshastikam, in the third verse, Trinadapi Sunichena Karorapi Sahishnuna Amanina Manadena Kirtaniya Sada. Right? It's Amanina Manadena. You offer all respect to others and you don't want respect for yourself. And when you have that mood, then you will chant constantly. But Daksha didn't have that kind of mood.
Daksha 没有这种心态.
He had some knowledge, but he was not able to properly understand Lord Shiva's position.
Daksha 他没有这样的心态，他没有这种知识，所以他不能正确的理解主师的地位。He
had some knowledge, but he did not
apply it. 他没有把这知识运用。
He had not realized it. Right? So you get some people where you can read the book and you know everything, but doesn't mean you've understood it. Because it's not just only knowing what's in the book, but it's how to use it, how to apply it.
他才能得到觉悟。
So Daksha had a lot of knowledge. He was a great personality.
So Daksha, 他有很多的知识，他是很伟大的。
But he didn't know how to apply.
但是他不知道怎么去加以利用，怎么去实践。
He became affected by pride.
他被骄傲所影响。
Pride comes before the fall.
有一句谚语就是说，在一个人堕落之前，他是骄傲的。
So Daksha had become proud. He's thinking, Shiva is my son. He's married to my daughter. He's my son-in-law. He should respect me.
所以 Daksha 他就被这种骄傲影响。他想，现在主 Shiva 成了我的女婿，他应该尊重我。
So.This mood of being anxious for respect from others, you can see caused the fall down of Daksha.
这种的渴望得到别人的尊重，就导致了 Daksha 的堕落。
Even if you have such a big position like Daksha, if you become proud, you can fall down.
即便像 Daksha 这样崇高的人物，如果他骄傲了，也会堕落。
You take a higher position, you take a big position in the material world, then it's easier to fall down.
在物质世界，如果一个人处在很高的物质地位上，他更容易堕落。
Because you become attached to your position.
他会依附他的地位。
You become attached to people honoring you, respecting you.
他会依附于那些尊重他、崇拜他的人。
And then Daksha, he even expected Lord Shiva to be honoring him.
Daksha, 他就期待着主 Shiva 来赞扬他，赞美他。
So, knowledge is important, but knowledge is only the beginning. You have to go on and realize the knowledge.
知识是重要的，但是知识只是开始。人一个人接着必须还要觉悟这些知识。
So, Ramaharshan was in the Naimisharanya forest, and Lord Balaram came. When Lord Balaram came, everyone stood up to respect him.
Ramaharshan, 他当时就在森林里面在讲述经典。当主巴拉拉姆来的时候呢，所有人都起身来尊重他。
Except for Ramaharshan Sutta.
只有 Ramaharshan Sutta 没有起身。
So.Lord Balaram understood this Ramaharshan Sutta is not very humble. And Lord Balaram took a kusha blade of kusha grass and pierced his heart with it.
Balarama 就拿了一根古萨草，就刺中了他的心脏。
So, Ramaharshan Sutta was killed by Lord Balaram. Ramaharshan was killed by Lord Balaram.
Ramaharshan 就被 Balarama 所杀。
But here you have Daksha. Now Daksha is not the Supreme Lord.
那现在呢 ？Daksha 他坐在那 ，Daksha 可不是至尊主。
Lord Shiva is above. He's much on a much higher position than Daksha.
主 Shiva 他比 Daksha 的地位要更高得多。
So Lord Shiva
至尊主。
When somebody like Daksha comes in, you don't have to stand up and respect him if you're Lord Shiva.
像 Daksha 这样的人物他来了主师们没有必要去向他尊重他
Very different from Ramaharshan Sutta
那跟 Ramaharshan 的情况截然不同 在物质世界从事风爱服务是受灰神的内在能量控制还是受半神人的控制。In the material world, devotees who engage in the devotional service, they are under the control of internal energy or the control of demigods.
In the material world,
people who are engaged in devotional service
are they under the control of
demigods
or
internal energy?
They're under the protection of the divine energy.
他们是在神圣能量的保护之下。
Mahatmanas Pramam Partam Taibin Prakriti Masha Bajanti Aminamanaso Yata Bhutti. The great souls sit under the protection of my divine energy. The demigods bestow their blessings on all the devotees.
在物质世界从事奉爱服务的人们，他们是处在我的神圣能量的保护之下，半神人会赐福于这些人。
One who has taken full shelter of the Lord, then he is not under control of the demons.
一个完全脱离至尊主的人，他们不受半神的控制。He's
free from the material.
他们摆脱了物质能量的控制。
So the demigods offer their respects to the devotees. The devotee's position is higher than the demigods. It says the devotees whose lips are always decorated with prayers to the Lord, to the Supreme Lord, are always given respect by saintly persons. And such persons are worshipable by the demigods. Because the roots are always chanting, they're always serving the Lord.
因为他们的双唇总是在唱诵，总是在服务至尊主。
Daksha
is Manu for mankind.
What?
Manu. Why he's always cursing? He has cursed many demigods, including Lord Shiva, Durga, Narada Muni. These greatly personality have no fault. When people are cursing, what's the base for their cursing? That's the question.
Well, this is the nature of people in the world of passion and ignorance. Even though Daksha has a big position, he's meant to be in the mode of goodness. The nature of the mode of goodness is such that sometimes it's conquered by passion and
ignorance.
If one is not properly engaged in devotional service, then he can fall down to the modes of passion. And if you curse someone, you have some bad feeling towards someone, and you curse someone, then the result is in the future somebody may curse you.
那如果一个人他心情不好的时候，他要诅咒别的时候，那么结果就是他未来他也会被别人所诅咒。Yeah,
you do harm, you have some bad feeling, ill feelings, you try to do harm, bring harm to someone, in the future the same thing will come back to you.
一个人他被伤害，然后他的感情受到伤害，他就想要诅咒别人，但是在将来他也会同样得到别人的诅咒。
Get some reaction.
他为此要承担后果，业报。The other question.
The
Hare Krishna Prabhupada, obeisance to lotus feet. My question is that the devotee, can devotees accept the gifts from non-devotees?
Accept gift from non-devotees. No, you can accept. It's nice you accept their gift. If they give you a gift, you can use their gift in the service of Krishna.
不违法，你可以接受，你可以把这些接受的礼物用来做奉爱服务。
Yeah, and that gives them an opportunity to advance in Krishna consciousness.
给这些奉献者机会，让他们在Krishna世界中进步。
If somebody gives you a gift, they're not devotee, they may become a devotee by giving you a gift.
如果有奉献，这些人给你的礼物，你接受他们的礼物，他们就有机会成为奉献者。
But the gift they give you, you should use for the service of Krishna.
他们把这些礼物给你，但是你一定要把这些礼物拿来做奉爱服务。
Can they make prasadam also and we can accept it?
Well, can they cook for fish? Can they cook for us?
Yeah.
Well, if they're not devotees, we wouldn't. We don't accept food cooked by non-devotees.
Yeah. Sometimes they insist that they want to cook for Krishna, but they are not following the regulative principles. But they insist so much that they want to cook for Krishna, and it's becoming a big dilemma whether to give them a service or...
刚刚那些问题就是说非奉献者给 Krishna, 他们特别想要给
Yeah, many people like to cook for Krishna, but they want to cook for Krishna, they have to be qualified. They may cook for Krishna, but if they're not following the rules and regulations, Krishna won't want to eat their food.
他们可能为 Krishna 做饭，但是如果他们不遵守规范原则， Krishna 可能不吃。
They can say I'm cooking for Krishna, but we don't know if Krishna will accept what they cook.
他们可能会说，我给 Krishna 做饭了，但是我们并不知道 Krishna 真的吃没吃这些。
So sometimes, you know, people do like that. They would come to the temple and they bring something. They say, I cooked something for Krishna. But if they're not devotees, we may accept it, but you wouldn't tell devotees, we would tell our initiated devotees, you know better, you don't eat this.
Can
distribute it to people who are, you know, just not very regular guests or something, not strict vegetarian, then there's no harm to distribute to them. Somebody's following the four principles but not chanting Hare Krishna. So can we distribute their prasadam? The same thing. If they're not chanting Hare Krishna, not really so good to offer to Krishna.
同样跟刚才的问题一样，如果他们不唱 Hare Krishna， 所以最好还是不要供奉给 Krishna。
Somebody's not chanting the holy name means they don't have much devotion for Krishna.
如果他们圣名不唱诵的话，就说明对 Krishna 没有很多的奉爱。
So an important qualification for offering food to Krishna is devotion.
所以给 Krishna 供奉食物的一个重要的元素就是有奉爱。
Well, somebody is a vegetarian. Krishna doesn't care. Just somebody is a vegetarian.
即便一个人他是素食者 ，Krishna 也不会很在乎。
So many vegetarians, but they're not devotees.
有这么多素食者，他们不是奉献者。
They should chant the holy name.
他也应该唱诵圣名。
Krishna consciousness begins with the chanting of the holy name.
Krishna 知觉是从唱诵圣名开始。
The first thing we do, we want people to chant the holy name.
我们第一件事情就是希望人们唱诵圣名。
That's how we begin Krishna consciousness.
这是一个人开始 Krishna 知觉的开端。
Rules and regulations they come granted.
随后才会有慢慢的遵守规范原则。
And the cooking is very important part. Krishna consciousness.
烹饪是 Krishna 知觉重要的组成部分。
So the kitchen and the altar are for the brahmanas, the twice initiated devotees.
厨房和神坛是那些 brahmana 二次起名的人。
Because if someone's not pure and they cook, then their karma will be in the food.
如果一个人不纯粹的话，他们的业报就在食物当中。
What is in China when the disease comes begins from the mouth, right?
Oh, 在中国有句谚语叫病从口入。
So what you put in the mouth is very important.
所以我们放在口里的食物是很重要的。
You want to only put prasadam in the mouth.
我们只应该把 prasadam 放在口中。
But it should be good, real prasada.
但应该是真正的 prasada.
Cooked by some qualified devotee.
有资格的奉献者所做的 prasada.
Then that prasada is very powerful.
这样的 prasada 才是有力量的。
Somebody comes back from Puri or Vrindavan. Did you bring any prasada? Oh, Vrindavan prasada. I want to take some.
如果一个奉献者从文大曼或者是扎达那夫人回来的时候，奉献者都会问他：“哎，你有没有带口沙等回来？”他们就很渴望得到这样的口沙
等。It must be very powerful for some.
那这种口沙等是一定是很有力量的沙等。
听布鲁讲，出席可以任何人来带。请问，出席项链带几圈有规定吗？
看不清了。New Body in Krishna Consciousness. I have heard from Guru that anybody can wear 出席 counting mala classic. May I ask?Are there any regulation? How many rounds of Tulsi Panimala should we wear? How many?
Well, initiated devotees should wear at least three.
Oh, 起居的奉献者至少戴三圈儿。
There's no other regulation.
其他的没有规定。
就是刚才顾妈妈是讲，就是说纯粹的奉献的能得到半圣人的庇护，但是呢，我想就是在我们学习和修复的过程中，这些奉献的也很多嘛，在这样的过程中，是不是也是否能得到半圣人的庇护？
看 Sadhaka devotees also get shelter from demigods.
According to their sadhana.
至少根据他们的规范修行。
Depending on how good you do your sadhana.
那要根据你做你的规范修行做得多好程度。
As you surrender, Krishna rewards your devotees.
Krishna 会依据一个人的臣服的程度来给予相应的回报。
If you do very good straight sadhana, then you will get shelter.
如果你做的是非常好的、严格的 sadhana 规范修行，会得到庇护。
Okay.